What a pleasure. Make some noise for Eve, your amazing MC tonight. My word. So lovely. It's a divine pleasure, folks. As you can already tell, get settled in, because we're in the domain of 7 hours of jazz poetry and death metal. You knew it was coming, guys. Here it is. So my first jazz poem that I'd like to play for you tonight. This is a poem about addiction. If you'd like to click along, you can. This poem is called Crystal Meth. That's good. Jazz. Mates. In tracksuits. Searching. An Essex warehouse. Rocks hidden by a weird man. No, sorry guys, I've mucked that one up. That poem is called Crystal Maze. If you were born in the 90s, you will not get that. I think it started up again last night with Richie Aldrati. So, good, my material's going to come back around again. I'm delighted. Guys, I've been living in London for 7 years now, and I'm recently single, and it's been a bit sad. But what I've realised is that love is everywhere that you look around, and this is a song of romance in our very fair city of London. And it goes a little something like this. The door slid shut, our eyes meet as we both clock the empty seat. An awkward smile, an open hand, I take the rail and say I'll stand. I look away, gripped one-handed, trying to focus on my evening standard. I look back, I think she's single, she's looking at me, not her Amazon Kindle. My heart beats fast and faster still, the next station stop is Tower Hill. I check the map, two stops remain, I go for broke and ask her name. What is your name? Victoria, I'm just hoping you'll take a chancery lane on me. My cock fosters desire for you, angel, it'll be a jubilee. And if my signal fails when we marrow the bone, I know you'll keep your head, just take my wood lane in your hand and bank me off instead. Romance. She looked like I was barking mad. Can't hide, park or corner the thoughts I had. These feelings are real, I'm not acting. Her arsenal was so distracting. A small rice lip turned things obscene. Some guys getting jealous, turn them green. My burrow's sweating, whopping moisture. She let me swipe her topped up oyster. To get in the tube was quite a push, so I went down on Shepherd's Bush. I put my monument in her mouth, cause I didn't want to catch the clap and sound. This is the final chorus where this song terminates. All key change, please. Oh, Victoria, I'm just hoping you'll take a chance or relay on me. My cock fosters desire for you, angel, it'll be a jubilee. And if there's planned engineering on your central line, we'll find another route. Baby, let's just cuddle. I put your finger in my mud chute. Choo-choo, choo-choo-choo, Victoria. That's very kind. Guys, I promise you death metal and I always deliver. I've been thinking a lot about death recently. I'm writing an Edinburgh show about death. And one of the things that I realized as a kid was I was never really introduced to the concept of death or change in any meaningful way. And so what I've tried to do is, I've tried to essentially change the theme tune of my favorite TV program as a kid to make the concepts of death a little bit more accessible to kids. So my favorite kids TV show was a show called Pingu. Any Pingu fans in the room? Rah. For those of you who are not aware of his excellent work, Pingu is a very small plasticine penguin. He lives in the South Pole with a lot of his mates, and shit gets real. Mate, if you've not seen season 11, you are missing out. It's on Netflix. So, guys, this is my death metal version of the Pingu theme tune. I hope it's that table slapping, is that kind of vibe. You can be the drummer. This is death metal Pingu.
A scene of death, a tale of hatred on a winter's night, a silhouette. The splash of red against the frozen white.
Your skin is cold,
black as the icy sky from whence you came. I sold my soul
to know the truth behind your hollow name.
Pingu, Pingu, your betrayal stains your evil flipper.
Stab your mother with a frozen skipper.
As the cold plasticine corpse of Pingu's murdered mother floats down to the murky depths of the cold cling film sea. Icing sugar snow covers a solitary polystyrene igloo. Robbie the Seal's cold, grey, clay body lies broken and massacred on the cotton wool ground. There is but one way out for Pingu now, as Kipper in Flipper, Pingu sheds one final Play-Doh tear as he sings his final lament across the fragile cardboard wasteland of his impending doom. Ladies and gentlemen, I've been Dan Attfield. You've been an absolute delight. Thank you so much.